ogni cittadino in presenza di un reato ha il dovere morale di intervenire.
That's the voice of Pietro Mancini. He used to work for Solvay, one of the world's largest chemical companies. You won't see his face because he wants to protect his family. He became a whistleblower, informing Italian authorities about pollution at the plant in Spinetta Marengo. An investigation by the International Consortium of Investigative Journalists provides new details on the events following the authorities' inquiry.
Solvay is the industry leader in specialty polymers.
You'll find us in the small details of the everyday. Those little details that make life safer, cleaner, healthier.
Solvay is one of the world's largest producers of high-strength plastics. It also makes chemicals for non-stick pans and electric cars. The company was founded by two Belgian brothers and entrepreneurs. Their descendants control Solvay today. The family's motto was to live happy, live hidden.
This family business that has always met the challenges of its time is more alive than ever.
In 2001, Solvay bought the Italian company Ausimont and its plants in the US, Italy and other countries. The contract stated that a New Jersey plant had released pollutants in the water and that the plant in Spinetta Marengo had a soil and groundwater contamination problem. Claudio Lombardi worked for the township.
Qui a Spinetta Marengo c'è un reparto bicromati, nel quale l'installazione di gas acidi foravano il setto nasale dei lavoratori. Chi lavorava lì era chiamata la tribù dei nasi forati.
As the new owner, Solvay agreed to clean up the site, but the plant continued to leak toxic chemicals.
Se non mi ricordo male, era il 2005, fece una marea di neve, ma ne fece veramente tanta, e l'acqua arrivò un po' dappertutto. La cantina di laboratorio, mettiamola così, dove tenevamo la vetreria, dove avevamo alcune cose, allagata nel vero senso della parola, mezzo metro d'acqua. E quest'acqua, quando alla fine defluì piano piano, nei muri diventò tutto giallo. Mandai le foto che si vedeva il giallo uscire praticamente tra il pavimento e il battiscopa, ok?
We found his photos on this old blog. The yellow sludge was hexavalent chromium, a chemical that can cause cancer.
Gli scarti di produzione erano stati interrati proprio in quella zona. L'acqua è salita, si è portato il metallo pesante. Quando poi se n'è andato, il metallo pesante è rimasto lì.
Solvay shut down the area where the chemical was found and fired Mancini. He sued the company and settled. Solvay said he was fired for just cause. Years later, Alberto Maffiotti and his team at the city's environmental agency made an unsettling discovery.
Attraverso un vecchio pozzo veniamo a conoscenza in maniera provata dell'inquinamento, quindi ricostruiamo al contrario.
Officials found high levels of hexavalent chromium and other pollutants outside the plant and in wells that supplied water to dozens of families living nearby and to coffee machines inside the plant.
Io la cosa che più mi ha fatto imbufalire è stata quella delle macchinette del caffè agganciate al pozzotto. Voglio dire, ma sai quanti caffè si bevono in uno stabilimento che fa tre turni?
Italian police launched an investigation, seizing thousands of Solvay documents. That's when attorney Vittorio Spallasso learned that the company kept two sets of records. He represented concerned residents.
Avevano anche acquisito dei doppi file dove venivano notiziati gli enti della presenza degli inquinanti in falda, però minimizzando i risultati, edulcorandoli, e dei file invece che contenevano i veri valori che erano stati ritrovati.
In 2009, prosecutors charged executives working for Solvay and the plant's old owner, accusing them of failing to clean up the site and intentional contamination. ICIJ has received confidential records belonging to a financial service provider in Singapore. Some show how, while the investigation was underway, members of Solvay's founding family moved millions offshore, setting up trusts and companies in tax havens. One of those members was Bernard de la Guiche. He was also one of the Solvay executives charged as part of the Italian case. This corporate video shows him with other directors. De la Guiche had signed the deal that led to the acquisition of the plants. In all, De la Guiche and other members of Solvay's founding family transferred more than $50 million to countries with laws that could shield their assets from creditors and courts. Those assets included Solvay's stock.
Trusts effectively are legal entities. And legal entities are very powerful ways to move stuff around and confuse issues of tax.
We asked law professor Eric Cates about the use of offshore trusts.
Trusts are increasingly being used by wealthy people to protect their assets from anyone that might have a claim against them. Secrecy is incredibly valuable with wealth, right? If your wealth is secret, where do your creditors go to find it?
While members of Solvay's founding family had moved part of their fortune offshore, some New Jersey residents were becoming alarmed about a different class of chemicals released by a Solvay factory. Tracy Carluccio is an environmental advocate. She uncovered all government reports on the plant emissions.
And we were shocked. We were startled by how much PFAS was in many drinking water systems.
Authorities had found high concentrations of fluorinated chemicals known as PFAS in drinking water supplies. Studies link the chemicals to cancer and other diseases. Many remain unregulated.
And there was really a lot of trauma amongst the people in the community that we've been drinking water that has been contaminated with this poisonous substance from Solvay.
Some residents sued the company and settled. Solvay did not admit wrongdoing. Still today, people living near the plant are concerned by the chemicals in their water. In West Deptford, Marilyn Quinn can see the plant from her garden. She recently hired a plumber to install special water filters.
I mainly wanted it for things that this company is spewing out. PFOS, PFNA.
Yeah, I've dealt with PFOAs. You know, you gotta have the right stuff to treat it.
The filter is the only solution I have for myself at this point.
In 2015, an Italian court found Solvay and several former managers guilty of causing environmental damage. Two of them reported directly to De La Guiche, but De La Guiche and another Belgian manager who had maintained their innocence were acquitted. De La Guiche did not comment on the case. He told ICIJ that he did not set up the trusts in response to the lawsuits, and that he has met all reporting and other obligations vis-à-vis tax authorities and market regulators. By the time the court ruled, De La Guiche had closed his trusts. Other members of Solvay's founding family kept their multi-million dollar assets offshore. Around the time the court issued its verdict, Pietro Mancini was recovering from surgery to remove a cancerous tumor from his right kidney.
Meno male che sono andato via dalla Spinetta.
Mancini says he has no regrets and that he'd speak up again.
Probabilmente lo rifarei proprio perché non ho accettato di essere complice.
In 2019, Italian researchers found that people living near the plant had a higher risk of developing stomach cancer and other diseases. Solvay said the study doesn't show any link between the plant and health risks, and that the company has invested heavily and taken actions to remediate the site.
Per me è cambiato ben poco.
Margherita Mancuso lives in Spinetta Marengo.
Perché l'inquinamento continua a esserci.
Qui puntata, vedi, ci abitano. Siamo proprio appiccicate alla Solvay.
The plant is on the other side of this wall. To the right, you can see homes and gardens. Mancuso's father worked in the plant. In the early 90s, he was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer.
E lui comunque mi diceva che non voleva rimanere più qua prima che si accorgesse del suo male, perché fa tutto avvelenato, tutto inquinato.
Last year, she joined a new grassroots movement, Comitato Stop Solvay, the Committee to Stop Solvay.
Siamo tutta gente giovane, insomma, che lottiamo per la nostra salute e la salute dei cittadini. Lottiamo per arrivare a un punto che la Solvay almeno prenda questi provvedimenti, di fare queste bonifiche e di non ampliare questo polo perché è tutto un veleno.
È iniziata giovedì mattina l'ispezione dei carabinieri del NOE di Alessandria.
Early this year, Italian prosecutors launched a new inquiry into the plant's pollution control system. They are investigating whether it failed to prevent toxic chemicals from leaking into the water supply. Solve says the leaks were due to exceptional weather events. In New Jersey, the state has sued Solve to force the company to clean up the contaminated water and disclose the health risks of the chemicals it uses at the plant. The company denied wrongdoing and said it's cooperating with authorities. The case is ongoing.
For me, it's an ethical issue as well as a monetary one, because we're the ones that are going to pay in the end, health-wise, money-wise, climate-wise, and they're just going to walk away with a lot of money, I guess.